area. And yeah, that was during all that time. So yeah, I think they were like really on the lookout. And like the gel blasters did feel like real guns. So yeah, I could understand at a distance somebody would think that that's real. A BB gun, airsoft, whatever it's called. Nosy neighbor must be terrified. I think, look, I can understand what he was doing. He had 4 kids, all under 15, and he's probably, like, for their safety, keeping an eye out, right? So I understood what he was doing, right? He was probably making sure that we weren't about to, like, shoot up the neighborhood or something like that, you know? Where did I just go then? Alright, I think I've got to run up here. Yeah, cool. Sorry, I got lost. But yeah, no, I understand what he was doing. Out of, like, legitimate concern for his family, he was keeping an eye on us. And that's fair. But yeah, he was not being subtle about the whole thing, which was probably the funniest part. I don't know if I can go that way or if that was a dead end. There's a section down here I haven't gone into. So we'll see if I can get back there. I think that that's where I've got to go. By the look of everything. I don't know if I'm going the right way. Sort of, maybe. Possibly. Yes. Yeah. Oh man. Well, like, just happened to find my way through here. It's like, good job. Good job, me. The closest thing I've ever gotten to shooting somebody was with Nerf gun. Me and friend, was it? Were those at an arcade and decided to do drive by on unsuspecting people? Oh my god. Oh, look, okay, Nerf guns, if they were the newer editions, they do have like the red on the front of them. So at like close enough range, people could tell that that is a toy. But fuck. That's terrifying. I don't know. I actually grew up in a household where we actually did have a gun. So I don't think I've ever actually mentioned that before, but yeah, the household I grew up in, we had a gun. I won't go into what that was about. Oh, I've looped back. Fuck. It must be over there then. I have to find my way back. Yeah, anyway. So, where do I go through here? I don't know. Probably the closest I've got to accidentally, like, I don't know, hitting somebody is in archery, realistically. That's just because they allowed people to walk out on the range while people were still firing, which is stupid. You shouldn't do that. That's a safety hazard. But I also hit myself with the bow drawstring so fucking hard. I left like a huge bruise on the inside of my arm. It was fucking painful. Oh yeah, this is it. It was so painful. I couldn't even like have air breeze up against my arm like a week. It was like so purple too. I never thought that like a bowstring could hurt that much, but I was too young to do paintball when we did go and do paintball and stuff. I think it was like, it must have been like my brother's birthday or work event or something. And oh, here we are. We're nearly there. And yeah, I was too young by like 2 weeks. So I didn't end up participating. But I remember my brother coming out of the scenario and he was purple all over. So many people hit him in the head.
Good riddance, freak.
He's super tall. So, yeah, he unfortunately got, like, hit in the head a lot. Honestly, if I had been playing, I probably would have done the same thing. But if I had been playing, my brother would have just spent the entire day hunting me down. I already know it. Return to town for more information. Nice. So I did paintball when I was younger. My friend's dad owned a towing company, so got to play in the junkyard. But see, when I was younger...
Seekers of the tomb of Tal Rasha will find it through the portal, but know that the glowing glyphs recorded here in my arcane sanctuary are the signs of the 6 false tombs. The missing seventh sign marks the tomb of Tal Rasha. Of the Herodrum, he might be called the foremost. It was a shining but brief moment for the mage clans when they set aside their differences and worked together against the common enemy. The Herodrum relentlessly pursued the three across the desolate empires of the east and even into the uncharted lands of the west, leaving the Archangel Tyriel's hands unblemished. Presuming the three to be vanquished, the Herodrum's unstable fellowship began to dissipate, abandoning their sacred charge to safeguard the three soul stones. The disparate mage clans began to squabble amongst each other over petty differences. Their conflicts not only dissolved their brotherhood, but strengthened the evils which they had buried beneath the cold earth.
Also, if anybody heard like a crunch noise in amongst that, that was my neck. Please. Canyon of the Mage. I think I've got to go. I mean, I don't have to go back, but I might go back. And then I'll go through there. Oh, that looks so awesome next to it. Hold on. Oh, wow. I haven't actually got them line up like this before. That's awesome. I didn't realize that, like, they've radiated so much. I have no fucking clue what I was saying before. Oh yeah, the paintball stuff. I would have loved to have done paintball, honestly.
Greetings.
I was just like 2 weeks too young to be able to participate. Like, I think the cutoff... Oh, you want to talk to me too. Like, the cutoff was like... I think either like 16, I think you had to be here.
Good to see
you. So I couldn't play because I was like 2 weeks before my 16th birthday. But yeah, that really sucked. But as I got older, like, I'm not that interested in going and playing and stuff, because, like, at least the fields that we have where I am, like, there's no, like, actual toilets or anything like that. Like, for me, with, like, my multiple medical conditions, that would be really problematic for me to get out. Also, let me know if there's any kind of lag and stuff like that, because my Streamlabs looks like it's really chugging, and I'm not sure how that's affecting stream. Let me know.
You must move quickly now, friend. For Diablo is undoubtedly close to finding what he seeks. Find the tomb of Tal Rasha before he frees the Lord of Destruction. I hope that this false summoner found peace in death. Unfortunately, it is more likely that he will be dragged down into hell by the demons he was bound to. Let this be a lesson to you. Demonic magic is a quick path, but its powers are seductive and deadly.
Huh. Oh, I didn't find my stuff. Oh, by the way, Streamlabs is like lagging behind for me. I haven't got the actual message that I can read just yet. Hold on. Although I did see Mathless's one pop up that said that it's all running fine, which is good. If it's going slow, what I might do is I'll pull the other one up in front. The Twitch web page, so I can actually see what I'm seeing. I got some good news, but I'm not sure how to feel. Why is that?
Blessings. Hi, Baron.
Let's talk. Seven tombs? Or is it summoner you're talking about?
Legend has it that Tal Rasha lies imprisoned within his tomb, forever struggling to keep the Lord of Destruction bound. His was a selfless act, although perhaps foolhardy.
Yeah. West log. Oh, both at the same time. What was the other one? Arcane Sanctuary and Summoner. I've still got to do that. Oh, it's the square. I haven't had the square for so many years. I always get like the weird fucking symbols. I'll show you when we go back in there. I'll point to the ones that I get the most. I never get the square. That's awesome. What do you want to say, Lysander?
When Tal Rasha chose to embody the spirit of Baal, he knew his doom was to wrestle eternally against the will of the greater evil. Look around you and ask yourself, has the battle been won or lost?
I applied for therapy today, and when I come back from vacation next week, I'll have an appointment with them. Nice! That's awesome. I'm always, like, fucking advocate for, like, therapy in any capacity. It's one of those things where it's, for some reason, stigmatized so badly. But it's one of those things where it's actually really healthy. Like, if you have, like, a broken arm or something like that, you go to a doctor to fix the broken arm, right? If you have, like, if you have any kind of, like, not so much, like, damage or whatever, but, like, if you've got any kind of, like, ill situation going on or whatever, like, having somebody to talk to, even just having a third-party person to talk to is really awesome. I almost kept that. 66 a life, though. Where's the mana? 66 a life isn't that... It's good. Not that good. I mean, I'm still gonna need shit. My first time and don't know how, it feels weird. Yeah, therapy can be like that though. Thing is, like, so different therapists are, let's put that back. Different therapists can be like a different feeling when you go and see them and talk to them and stuff like that. So what I sort of mean by that is, like, one therapist might be like really, really great. Like, you go there and you feel very understood. They listen very well. Sometimes you'll get one that's not that great. Like, you won't feel heard, or, you know, you won't feel like you can comfortably speak with them and stuff like that. Like, I really do hope that, like, you get a really good one, like, up front. Because honestly, everybody deserves to get a good fucking therapist first go, realistically.
I've heard legends of the tomb of Tal Rasha. But I thought they were just old tales meant to scare young children.
I don't think anybody else in town should have something to say. I don't know why my internet's struggling so much. Hold on, let me just check a couple of things. My task manager. What is chugging? Diablo and Stream Elements is using a fair bit together. That's it. It's the only thing that's using anything. Alright. I don't know. It should be fine. Get rid of that. And yeah. Alright. Congrats. Therapy is fun. Is it? It can be. Yeah. So. Okay. So while I'm here, I get triangle a lot. And I've had this thing a fair bit. I don't usually get that. Like the half circle. I don't get the circle. I have had this one. I'm pretty sure I probably had one circle, but I get this one. I haven't had this one much. I usually just get the triangle and this one, right? They're the two that I usually get. But this time around, I got the square, which is cool because I almost never get the square. That's right. That's right. I should have just walked through and got the waypoint. Would have been great. Yeah, sometimes if you go to a therapist and stuff like that, you can really just feel, like, you know, calm and, like, a weight is off yourself. Sometimes appointments can be, whoa, shit, a little bit heavy and stuff like that, especially if they're emotional. But generally speaking, they're very good. They're very healthy for your body. It's kind of like, you know, when you're having, like, a really, really bad time, and you just cry lots and lots, and then when you've done crying, you start to feel better. It's kind of like that. It's, you know, you just kind of like let stuff out and you start feeling better, you know. It's like sharing the burden a little bit. That's at least how I sort of see it, is it takes all the weight off just being on you. I don't have room for that. There we go. That'll work. It's like talking about with good therapists. So I'm not sure what it's like, what I should expect. I think the best thing to do is to not have expectations going into it. I know that's really, really hard to do. But if you go into it without any specific expectations of, like, who they are or what they're going to be like or stuff like that, you'll find that it'll be a lot easier to accept who you have and how it is and stuff. know, it's really weird. I'm gonna go back through here so I can get in. But they will also probably ask you, like, did you, like, what were you expecting, or did you have any expectations of what to get out of these appointments? That is a big one they'll usually ask you, is like, do you have any expectations of what you want to get out of these appointments and stuff like this? Like, is there a goal that you're working towards? If you have a goal in mind, it's great to be honest and tell them. Because at least that way they can help work towards it with you. Or, like, let you know if perhaps that goal might be a little bit unrealistic or something like that. That's always a good one too, is if, like, they can put some perspective on how you're sort of, framing, like, your time frame and stuff for progress. I want to keep the mana, but I can't. Unfortunately, I don't have space. Yeah, alright, let's go back out. Let's see, what else is there? It's just like talking with therapists, you feel understood and listened to and fun, because during the talks you get to finally understand, oh, so that's why I'm reacting this way, and life gets easier. It is like that. If you get a really good therapist, it could be like having a really deep conversation with like a friend or somebody that you feel like you can genuinely be open with and stuff. Like, you know how sometimes talking to me away, but you often say that like you feel better after talking to me? It's a bit like that, except they can better understand what's happening and communicate that back to you. So that's sort of what it's like. So if you're a bit unsure or if you feel uneasy, just think of it like you're going to go and talk to a prelic. You know, think of it like that, if that is something that like you find makes you feel better, you know. Expectations, because I'm still not sure what to expect. That's fair. My helper died, unfortunately, so I'm gonna have to rebuy her. Because every therapist is different. We all go there for different reasons, I believe. Yes, that is 100% correct. Every therapist treats different things and has a different approach to how they treat the different things. Different people see different therapists for different reasons. It's exactly right. So, I don't know, sometimes people even just have therapists just for the purpose of having somebody that's not, you know, a friend or family or co-worker or a classmate or something like that, that can give them a perspective on stuff, you know. Sometimes it's nice to just have an external perspective on what's going on in life, you know. Mind me when I go back to town, I gotta find my helper. I will forget. The first couple of meetings will probably just be getting acquainted. Yeah, that's true as well, actually. A good therapist will be able to pick up on when you're ready to start sharing. Just remember, they're there to help. That is also true as well, so just remember that, like, when you're talking to a therapist and stuff like that, they are supposed to be there to help you. They are there for you. So there's nothing that you can say that is not going to be okay to talk to them about. Like, there's nothing that you're going to say that they're going to sit there and judge you for. Like, it is a place where you can be completely unapologetically safe and open with everything that's happening, or whatever you need to get off your chest, or, you know, whatever you need to work through and stuff. So yeah. We'll be back. No worries. Exactly. And I do think it takes time too.
I can't carry anymore.
I could go there once. All my problems go away. Yeah, it's, yeah, sorry, I read that wrong. It was, I don't think it's go there once and all problems go away. Funny enough that you say that, is when I was young, I believed that that's what would happen. I was like, yeah, one or two appointments that would be good. Everything would be solved and my life will be fucking sweet, you know? No, that's not how it works. It can take months and sometimes even years to get through like deeper or more complex kind of issues and stuff like that. And it also depends on what you're going there to see them for as well too. So it just depends. It's not a quick fix, but over the long term, it's like unraveling a knot, right? Is if you work at it a little bit all the time, more and more, eventually the knot will unravel and, you know, you'll be able to, like, release whatever has been tied up this whole time, kind of thing. I also really want to keep these. I'm going to start storing these in here. Alright? I just need to keep these. I know it's going to cap how much I can carry, but I just don't have the space. Until I can get rid of this motherfucker. Realistically. My cat just made a huge mess. It's fine. Hopefully they didn't dirty something. I know your cat's been struggling with stuff. Drying rack is on the stairs, but the drying rack fell from the stairs. I had to clean it up. That's fair. Hopefully it didn't, like, dirty whatever was, like, on the drying rack. You know? I'm just imagining a drying rack on a staircase, sorry. I'm trying to envision what kind of a drying rack. I'm unfamiliar. Like, we have drying racks and stuff like that here. For, like, well, different things, like hanging clothes to dry. And we have it for, like, sometimes for, like, washing, like dishwashing stuff. But yeah, I personally don't have a use any myself. I got a dryer. So my brain's drawing a blank on staircase thing. I love how, like, sometimes I just don't I forgot to buy my helper. Sometimes I don't have a point of reference for something, and it just, like, my brain just shuts down trying to, like, imagine what it is. You know? I'm getting, like, spears and shit thrown at me from all kinds of places, and I'm just like, mate, can you not? Like, scissor style, made of wood. That's sort of kind of what I'm sort of thinking of. It's, you know, like an X-shaped drying rack kind of thing that's got, like, maybe some wires or, like, a tray or something on the top of it is what that's what I'm imagining. The alternative thing I'm thinking of is, like, something that could hook into, like, parts on the wall or something, you know? And, that could hang above or below certain stuff without, like, obscuring passageway. Like, that's the other thing I'm thinking of too, because, like, the only real reference I've got to things that hang in, like, a point of, like, where you'd pass through would be, like, stuff that you'd hang up underneath the garage to, like, dry clothes and stuff when it's raining. Which I kind of wish I had one of those sometimes, because, like, I don't always want to have to run the dryer. Like, sometimes if I've got, like, towels or I've got, like, something along those lines that's a bit bigger, I'd love to just, like, hang it up. And just be like, cool, I'll come back to that in a couple of days when I need it next. Instead. Fucking hell. One of my fingers has been really fucking sore tonight. I don't know why. Ow. That was my knuckles. There you go. I will stretch. Thank you, Shadow. Let's see. Grandma's drying rack is just like rope and hallway in her house. Yeah, see, that's sort of what I'm kind of imagining. Just like a clothesline. Drying rack is it's attached to a wall and like a half wall. And it just hangs. No, I understand what that is actually. When it's like a attached to a wall and it's like a half wall type thing as well. I actually know what that is. I can imagine the shit now. My brain has been refreshed. It's fantastic. I missed the hydrate. Hold on. I heard that. Yeah, sometimes when I crack my knuckles, I'm actually, like, overly close to the microphone, but my neck and my shoulder and my hands have been really, really cracky in the last 24 hours. Like, a lot of my body has been really, really aching really badly. I don't fucking understand why. I haven't done anything. Like, I've literally just existed, and my body... I woke up this afternoon. Actually, I woke up in pain. I woke up and I'm like, oh, if I can, I'll go back to sleep for a bit. And I sort of rolled over and, like, my leg and a whole bunch of bits and pieces were, like, really sore. And I'm like, why? The fuck happened here? Kind of thing. And yeah, I don't know. It's gonna move those over and see if I don't use them as much. I've been pretty good at not using them lately. So we'll see. Alright. I'm surprised, you know. I sort of know some of this stuff from, like, different people. Also, sometimes TV movies, stuff like that. Like, sometimes a little bit of a description is enough for me to pick up on what the fuck, you know? Other times, like, I just don't know. I forgot to buy my helper again. God damn it. Please remind me when I go back to town. I need to remember to buy her. I just need, like, the extra arrows, you know, basically. Stormy low pressure makes bones ache. That's a good point. I don't think so. Like, it hasn't been, like, rainy or thunder or any kind of, like, low cloud cover or anything like that. I'm trying to think of, like, what the weather has been like. It's just been kind of, like, normal-ish, kind of, like, mild winter sun. I don't even know if it's been cloudy. I'm not sure. But, that would make sense, because, like, there is... I can't remember what type of storm it is exactly. I think it's when it's nearly gonna hail. I think that's when I'm usually in the most pain, but... this isn't kind of the season to get hail. There's winter, so... If it was gonna hail, it would hail in summer. You know? Yeah. I don't know. I don't like emojis. Why? What for? Oh yeah. Sorry, the temples. I hadn't come across them yet. I came across one and I ran away. Looked dumb. Yeah, but why? Like, are we talking about the standard, like, little yellow ones that, like, are in, like, every phone and, like, most kind of, like, digital stuff? Or are we talking about, like, some other ones? Because, like, there are some out there that's kind of like, what the fuck? Yeah, it's winter, it's summer for me. Yeah. Yeah, we're in winter in Australia. Usually in winter... So, let me get back down to the corner here and I'll start going up and beyond this place. So, usually in winter, I tend to feel, like, a lot of soreness, a lot of tiredness kind of thing from the cold weather. It takes my body a lot of energy to get warm and stay warm. So a lot of the time I can't kind of warm up, right? So winter's usually the problem season for me because I have a lot of like old injuries, medical conditions, blah, 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 that everything hurts, right? So it's not my best season, right? But then like I usually like summer because it's warm and I can go into spaces to cool down and it's more comfortable for me because everything's kind of warmed up, like limbered up kind of thing, which is nice. Last summer was brutal because I couldn't escape the heat and it was basically trying to kill me. But yeah, I sort of got past that sort of thing. And then this winter has just, yeah, Everything hurts in a way that it doesn't normally. So it's weird to explain. Like, I don't know if shit just hurts more or whatever. Like, I feel like I need to go for a walk kind of thing. To like, I don't know if that would stretch everything out or if it would warm everything up. I don't know, but like, everything just is annoyingly achy. So I get weird reply. So I go to say something, I get a weird reply like, oh yeah, the stone face. And I hate that. See, however, I kind of like grew up in the time where like we were just getting to finally express ourselves as teenagers with emotes. So like it was fun for us to kind of play with that. Mind you, we didn't play with those, we just played with like, you know, the smiley face and shit like that. I can't fit that in my inventory. First things first. Let's go buy her before I forget. Go get her before I forget it. Yeah, no, like the emotes and stuff like that. There are some emotes that get used these days that are kind of like, what the fuck? why is it being used this way or something like that. But also, then you get like sentences made out of the emotes and stuff. Like, we used to play around with that a little bit when we were younger, but not that much, you know. And thank you for reminding me as well. Yes. Pain, poison, over damage. I'll take a look at that in a sec. If I forgot her again, like, I just want her to be running around with us, you know, because there's a good chance that she's gonna actually help maybe take stuff down a little bit easier. I don't know if there's anything that's better than that. 15 poison damage over 4 seconds. Not really. Not in, like, the big ones, and I'm only replacing the big ones if I can, so that's fine. I need portals. I need town portals. How cold does it get there in the negatives? So, where I am in Australia, we have tropical weather, right? So you've got to remember that when it's summertime, we have like humidity and we have like really, really strong sun and stuff like that. So it's when it's hot, it's like really either really, really dry hot or it's really, really like humid hot. And when it's humid hot, I get nosebleeds and I faint and all sorts of stuff from my anemia and